What is a Google Ads forecasting tool and why do you need it? A forecasting tool? It is the heart and the soul of your ads campaigns. Never, ever start an ad without having run your numbers in a Google Ads budget planner first. And in this video, I'm going to show you the same tool that I use to forecast my Google Ads before I'll spend a single dime. Stick around till the end, and I'll even show you how to get a free copy of my forecast tool. Hey everyone, I'm Richard Cruz. My agency tests and develops cutting-edge Google Ads strategy every single day. And in these videos, we share with you the best tips and strategies to help you get better results with your Google Ads campaigns. Before we get rolling, click the subscribe button if you'd like to receive free Google Ads tips and be alerted when they're coming out. So, have you ever been in a cockpit of an airplane and you see all the buttons and the levers and the gauges that that cockpit has? They can be extremely overwhelming. And with so many buttons and gauges, a pilot cannot ever rely on memory. So every pilot has a pre-flight checklist that they go through step by step to ensure that everything is 100% every single time. Google Ads? It's really, really similar. There are literally hundreds, if not thousands, of variations in ad strategy and configurations that you can take that can make a massive difference between a campaign taking off, being profitable, making you money, being successful, or crashing and burning. And that's why to this day, even though I can do it almost in my sleep, I never start a campaign without my checklist. And one of the steps in my checklist, and in my opinion, probably the most important step because it surrounds the money issue, one of the most important steps is my checklist. It's my Google Ads forecasting tool. It's one of the very first steps that I'll always take, and I want to know exactly what our goals and our projections are, and so you should also if you're going to be running Google Ads. So look, this is not Vegas, folks, where you go to Vegas and roll the dice and you hope that your campaign is going to give you a profitable ROI. It takes planning. It takes direction with your Google Ads budget all done through the tool and the planner. So step number one is to forecast Google Ads, is to set up targets and measure the goals while your campaign is running, keeping an eye on those numbers and keep improving them. A campaign is so dynamic, where you're watching these numbers and these key metrics like a hawk, and you're making those necessary adjustments as needed to stay on track with your pre-planned Google Ads estimate costs. The numbers that you need to watch are the following. So some of them is your impressions, your CTR, your click-through rate, your obviously number of clicks, your CPC, your cost per clicks, your total cost, your conversion rate, and obviously the number of conversions or the number of leads. And there are so many more numbers, but to me, those are the most important. If you're keeping an eye on those, you can navigate really well. And so let's go ahead and take a look at the process of this Google Ads cost and budget estimator. What I'll do is when I walk into a campaign that I'm going to do, the very first thing I want to know is what is the customer lifetime value? And this is not what your fee is for this service. This is what the lifetime value is. Let me give you an example. Let's say that you run a weight loss center. And so the average fee is say $600. Okay. But you know that that person is going to need to come back later on. There's going to be upsells. There's going to be cross sells. There's going to be referrals, especially if you're doing a good job. And you should know your numbers. And really, every new customer is worth a different lifetime value than the upfront money. And so you want to make sure that you understand what all of those are and you calculate what is my customer lifetime value. You have to know that when you're going into Google Ads. The reason why is if you go in with your 600 number in mind, and you start going for a campaign and you're trying to make a positive return on investment on that $600, your competitors are bidding against you based on a lifetime value. And so they're using a different set of numbers. They sometimes, I've seen it where they don't care if they make money up front because they know on the back end they're that building that value and they're going to make the money on the back end. And so you're going to lose out every single time in the auctions if you're not using the right number. So always make sure that you have done your homework and you find your true customer lifetime value. Once you've done that, you can plug that into the planner right here. And then what I want you to do is just figure out, hey, how many customers do you want? Do you want 10 customers? Do you want 50 customers? Let's just start here with 50 customers with a $1,200 average lifetime value. So here you're going to have a target revenue, obviously, of this times this, which is going to be $60,000 that you generate in revenue with your 50 customers. Step number two, what we do is we're going to work backwards. I want you to think about the position. Obviously, the end of the trail is how much revenue you're generating, correct? Your 50 customers, your $1,200 per, $60,000. But what I want you to think about is, what is your conversion ratio? I'm not talking about the conversion ratio in the ad account. This is your conversion ratio from leads to customers. And it can vary. It might be, say, 4 to 1. So for every 4 people that call you, you turn one into a customer. You might be at 90%. So know those numbers and plug that into the calculator right here. So, so important. Let's say, for example, you're at a 3 to 1. You know that for every 3 leads that you've got, one new sale that's going to come out of that. Now, in order to be able to hit your targets, the calculator is already telling you need to have about 152 leads. And this is the conversion rate that's going to be inside of the Google Ads account. And so, you know, what is that conversion rate going to look like? And that conversion rate is obviously going to be, you know, the clicks, the people who are coming through and converting off of your website, you know, for example, and are actually giving you a call. So let's just be conservative. Let's go with the number and let's say that, you know, you can plug in a 5%, 10%, 15%, 3%. You know, it really is going to vary. And you can go into Google Analytics and do some numbers and start understanding what some of your numbers are. But let's go ahead and go with a 5%. So if you've got 5% of people on your website contacting you, you're going to need about 3,000 clicks to get the 152 leads, to get the 50 customers that are coming to you. See how we're building up all the numbers backwards? And now, you know, you can do a little bit of keyword research. You can find out what your average cost per click is. But let's say, for example, I'm just going to use, say, $16 cost per click. So what is your ad click-through rate? And so, you know, you can have a click-through rate that is 1.5%, 3%, 5%. Those are, you know, some real typical ranges. Sometimes you'll get more, but let's say about a 3%. That's a good average number to shoot for. So we know that we need 100,000 impressions, and we will at that point estimate about $300 cost per lead. So you've got a cost per lead of $320. You are closing 1 to 3, so it's going to be costing you about $960 to make $1,200. So we know that we want to really improve the numbers. And the click-through rate, you want to have your best ads, your quality scores, all these things in line here to try to work on this number to be able to improve it. But your conversion rate on the website, again, having a really great website, making sure that you're going through your A-B testing, you're fixing those things. And then over here, you know, your closing rate, you could easily go in here and really work on your team and how you're answering the phones and picking up the phones quickly and having a good customer intake and be able to increase that to 50%. And let's say that you can increase here working on your website and you wind up being able to take this over to a 8%. Now, what starts happening is you are now averaging a $200 cost per lead. You're converting, you know, 1 to 2. And so it's now costing you about $400 to acquire a customer and you're generating $1,200 revenue. That's a huge difference. And that was just by watching two different numbers, the conversion rate here and the conversion rate right here. those little numbers will make or break your campaign in such a big way. And so now we set our targets. These are our targets based on the projections. And once we get rolling in the campaigns, we are now working on keywords that are in this range here. Let's say we can get a $10 cost per click average, right? That's going to start doing great things all the way across the board. And so we want to beat these baselines right here. We want to try to get the best cost per click. We want to get the best click-through rate, get the best conversion rates. All those little pieces are the difference between success and not so much success inside of a campaign. And that is my Google Ads budget planner and how to use it. And if you'd like to get a free copy, like I promised you in the beginning, go down to the chat down here and put your email in there in the comments below, and then I'll send you a copy, no charge. And if you found this Google Ads forecasting tool helpful, give this video a big thumbs up. Share it and subscribe so that you're alerted of future trainings like this in the future. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.